on the way.
No.
That's it.
Wait, guys. On the way.
To the camera?
Hey.
Hello.
Kyle, surprise.
Hi.
Somebody.
Polar bear!
Thank you.
very active. I know, look how big the head is compared to the body.
Guys, say hi. Hi. Grab Brandon's
hand. Wave to the camera.
Look.
3, 4, 5. Come on, my group, let's go.
My group.
Orange group, let's go. Sean.
This is it.
Say hi to the camera. Say hi to the camera. Hi, guys.
City of New York, and it provides a habitat for ducks, turtles, fish, and migrating birds. Now, Wayne's is the continent with the largest. And its appearance differs from the domestic horse. It has a stockier build, shorter legs, and an erect mane which resembles a Mohawk haircut, and that mane is also missing a forelock, the piece of hair which normally falls in front of a domestic horse's forehead. In the last 2 years, we've had 5 horses born here.
Colonel Nikolai Przewalski encountered the horse in Western Mongolia. Because of his discovery, this species is also known as Przewalski's horse.
Now, the Bronx Zoo participates in what's called a species survival plan, and here's some more information for you. Now, Yuri's father is also exhibited here, and his father is a good example of that species survival program you heard about. He's on loan to us from the Toronto Zoo, and he was brought here for breeding purposes, and he's been successful. Besides Yuri, there's another tiger over at Tiger Mountain. Now, elephants are... And the elephant's trunk is a remarkable tool that has over 40,000 muscles and a finger-like appendage at the end of it. And the elephant will use that appendage just like a hand to pluck grass from the ground so it can eat it, to throw dirt on its back to keep insects off, or it can use its trunk to rip down a tree with tremendous force. Poor eyesight, but they have a good sense of smell and good sense of hearing. And although they're such large animals, they can still run at speeds of up to 30 miles an hour. But that's not fast enough to outrun poachers who are hunting and killing the rhino for its horn.
The horn of a rhinoceros is very different from that of a goat or antelope. It is not attached to the skull. Rhino horn is made from compressed keratin fibers.
It's getting fed right now. That's the Nilgai antelope, and it's the largest antelope in Asia. In the Hindi language, the word Nilgai means blue bull because males will get a bluish tinge to their coat once they mature. Species are not closely related. They do share the same specialized diet of bamboo, and the word panda means bamboo eater. Red pandas are more closely related to skunks, raccoons, and weasels.
You guys see the gorillas?
Yeah.
My swollen finger! My finger's swollen!
Yeah.
Oh no!
Bonnie, is you okay? You alright? Who's your...
My name is Marianne, and my favorite part was,
Did you go to the door?
Going to the store.
Go ahead.
My name is Cynthia.
My favorite part. My favorite part was watching the snakes.
My name is Ariana. My favorite thing was the seals.
My name is Angelina. My favorite part was the monkeys.
My name is Taylor. My favorite part was the sea lions.
My name is Andre, and my favorite part was My favorite part was when we went to see a show. And then We learned that we're supposed to help other animals, get them food, and take care of other animals.
My name is JD, and my favorite part,
I thought it looked like a chair.
I saw this huge beetle. It was awesome.
My name is Juan Diego Lara, and my favorite part was when I saw this awesome tiger that was sleeping.
Hi, my name is Marcelo, and my favorite part was the leopards and the gorilla and getting my hands swollen.
My name is Devon, and my favorite part was to see the lions.
My favorite part was the zebras.
The lions.
My favorite part of the zoo is when we saw the elephants and we went on a monorail.
My favorite part of the zoo was the monorail.
Oh yeah, my favorite part would be the monkeys.
My favorite part would be the baboons.
It was when we saw the lions.
My favorite part was when we saw the polar bears.
My favorite part of the zoo.
My favorite part of the zoo was the reptile house.
When we went to the lions.
My favorite part of the zoo was when we went to the Dora 3D.
My name is Justin. My favorite part of the zoo was the reptiles, because I like snakes and turtles.
My name is Sean Venegas, and my favorite part was the tigers.
Look happy! Everybody say cheese!
Cheese!
Is that cool?
Yeah, it was cool.
Does this. He's saying hello to everybody. And when you
touch this shark, we ask that you only touch the underwater parts of this shark, just like this. Two fingers, touch his underwater part of his back. We do not touch it. This is definitely a big exhibit. We have three other exhibits. Sacred Beast, Speech Club, you guys all need to. Thank you, counselors, for helping the smaller children with touching the shark. Thank you very much, chaperones. Parents, you may need to help your children touch. Thank you.
Camden Aquarium Trip, Alcala Day Camp, Mr. Angelo's Orange Group. Guys, say hi to the camera, good beer. The shark from there, say hi to the camera. Wait for the camera. Are you guys having fun? Tell the camera. You guys having fun?
Is it open? Is it working? It's coming out? it up.
No, we can't. He's trying.
Aquarium is when we seen the movie Jaws.
My favorite part was seeing the sharks and the gift shop.
My favorite part was when we got to go and see a movie, and then we got to go downstairs and we got to see some sharks.
My favorite part is when we got to see the shark movie and got to see all the fishes and the starfishes.
My favorite part is when we saw all the sharks, even the hammerhead sharks.
I'm on TV!
Come on. Come on, guys. Look at you, you're staring at people. Guys, thank you.
War. Let me introduce you all. Over here, we have Christopher, Justin, Noel, and their anchor, Scooter, the Holy Cow. And over here, we have Lucy, Emily, Brianna, and Red, our very own Play Cow, as their anchor. All right, let's get set.
Yeah.
Cory.
One thing, no running at all. Counselors, I need you to monitor to make sure that nobody is running at all. This place is wet, it's slippery. Anybody could get hurt at any time. Yes, there are lifeguards around. Yes, there are EMTs around. But I cannot have you guys running around. Is that understood?
Yes.
I don't think I heard everybody. Is that understood?
Yes!
Okay.
We are gonna try to do this somewhat quickly because we know you guys are really looking forward to running around the water park. The first thing is we don't run in the water park. We'll explain why. So anyway, my name is Katie. I work at Sarah Sam's Oasis, but I am part of the Sambulance Safety Squad. What we do is we visit kids all over the whole entire state of New Jersey. We were 2 hours north yesterday. We go all the way down south, we go east, we go west. So we teach kids about emergencies, water safety. Today we're gonna go over water safety with you guys.
I have my buddy Janelle. I'm gonna say hi, Janelle.
Hi, Janelle.
Hi, Janelle.
I
want to see America's Next Top Model. Let's get a nice walk.
Yeah.
Oh, 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 oh.
Yes, Janelle. Spin, spin.
Good
yeah.
job.
I like it. Little head top at the end, you know.
Hi.
Yeah.
All right, Jake needs to watch out. All right. So, what do you guys think about this life jacket? Do you think it's a good life jacket? Who says yes?
Yes.
Who says no? Let's find out. First step, make sure everything's strapped on. This is good, this is good, this is good. I'm gonna have you take a nice deep breath. Was that hard or was it snug?
It was snug.
It was snug. A snug fit is a perfect fit. But there is one more test that you can do to find out whether if the life jacket is too big. And I'm gonna have Katie do it.
That is right. An easy way to tell is actually just to lift up at the shoulders. So if this was to lift all the way up to her face and up to her ears, that actually means when she jumps in the water, her life jacket will lift up like that too, which would make it really hard to swim as she'd be trying to swim like this. You can also tell it would be too big is if the armpits are the only thing that stops the life jacket. Because imagine if you jump in with your arms up, life jacket can even pop up over your head. And then what's the point of that?
Stage four.
Let's go.
Seizure, right? Hypoxic convulsion. Seizure. Oh, my God. All right, ready? Stage five. Stage five. We're all dead. All dead. Stage five. All dead. Ready? Stage one. Shock look, right? Shock look. You think. Oh, my God. I need help. I need help. Shock look. Oh, my God. Stage two. Involuntary breath holding. Stage three. Unconsciousness. Hello, floor, unconscious, we're all unconscious.
Oh my God.
camera on me.
All the guys that smile away.